for some reason I'm being reminded of a kid I met in Tulsa, Oklahoma one time, and he was maybe 21 years old, and he had just gotten back from serving his first tour in Iraq, and he came to me and he said this, he said, "Man, I've killed people. I looked at people's brothers, I looked at somebody's father, I looked at people's sons, and I took their life." And he said, "Is that a sin?" Man, I had to look at him and say, "Yeah, man, I'm sorry. Like, I know that your chaplain is telling you that it's not a sin because you're doing it for your country. And I know that mainstream Christianity is telling you that it's justified for some sort of weird political game. But the reality is, this kid was broken over the fact that he was a sinner. And he wasn't even able to approach the Savior until he was willing to confront his sin. Does that make sense? Like, he wasn't even able to see his need for a Savior until he saw the wretchedness of his own sin." Listen, and then I have people come up to me and tell me some of the most horrible things. Some of these terrible things that they've done, and they say, "I don't know if God can forgive me." And I always have the same answer. I say to them, "Do you know what you deserve? You deserve to get hung up on a cross, naked. You deserve to get beaten to within an inch of your life. Have a crown of thorns beaten down into your skull with rods. To be hung up, to be mocked, humiliated, spit on, and ultimately suffocate to death in public for what you've done." Oh, hallelujah. But somebody already paid that price for you, man. Oh. Somebody already stood face to face with the wrath of God so I would never have to. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus, and I call him Savior. Listen, man, I've said over and over again on this tour, I'm not here looking for people that have it all together. We're not, because if you have it all together, you're never going to know what it means to lean on Jesus. But I can tell you, every broken kid on this stage, every kid that should have been in jail, every kid that should have been raising a child with a woman he didn't care about, every kid that should have been hooked on drugs or alcohol on this stage knows what it means to depend on Jesus every moment of every day and every week of our life. So we're not looking for people to have it all together. We're looking for people that are disgusted with their sin. I'm looking for people that are broken over their own separation from God and the realization that it's your fault. God didn't leave you, he left him. And he made a way for you to come back to him through the death, and the burial, and the resurrection of his son Jesus. Jesus said, "If any man will lay down his life for my sake." Oh, hallelujah. "If any man would lose his life for my sake, he would gain it. If any man would seek to gain his life, he would lose it." So listen, I'm not looking for people who have lives that are to be admired, that have worldly success or fame, or that are trying to convince me that you have it all together. I'm looking for people that can look at the broken life in front of you and say, "Jesus, it's all I have to give, but you get all of it. It's all I have to give, but you deserve all of it. Jesus, this broken life is all I have, but I lay it at your feet and pray that you would accept it as an offering." So to every broken kid in this room, there's an open door into a new life through Jesus. So to everybody that's unsatisfied with the life you built for yourself, there's an open door into a life of destiny and purpose in Jesus. Oh, to every sinner, to every reject, to every outcast, to every kid that knows they were born for revolution because something's got to change in this life, there's an open door for you in Jesus Christ tonight. And this is your invitation.